गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन। इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद चैप्टर 12 इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट टू शो दैट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मटेरियल्स शो डिफरेंट रेजिस्टेंस और कंडक्टिविटी, राइट। सो हियर वी इन दिस एक्टिविटी द सेटअप इज सेम एज इट वॉज इन केस ऑफ ओम्स लॉ। वट वॉज देयर, वी हैव यूज एक्स वाई प्लेस एंड एट दैट एम्प्टी space, or you can say open circuit space, we are going to put three different types of materials or different types of devices. In first case, we will put the nichrome wire, we will note down the reading of ammeter, and in second case we will put the torch bulb, then we will put the 10 watt bulb, and we will note down every time the reading of ammeter. That means only current we are measuring, we are not measuring potential difference. What do you think, current in all the three cases will be same or different?
Ma'am, it will be different.
It will be different. Why? Because the current will be different for different components, because the certain components offer an easy path for the flow of electric current, while other resist the flow. So we have taken three devices, 10 watt bulb, torch bulb, and nichrome wire. What do you think? Which material will show more easy path for the flow of charges?
Ma'am, nichrome wire.
Nichrome wire. After that, which will show the easy path for current flow?
Ma'am, 10 watt bulb.
Torch bulb, beta, torch bulb. And then after 10 watt bulb. Because with the help of 1.5 volt battery, can you conduct charges through a nichrome wire? Can you conduct the charges?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes.
If it is thin, if it is thin wire. But if you have taken thick wire and you made a coil, but and you have made it a 10 watt bulb, can you conduct the charges through it? 10 watt bulb.
No, ma'am.
No, you need more potential difference. You need a battery of at least 10 volt or 12 volt so that the 10 watt bulb also glows. Agree? Agree? So that
yes,
is different components, because they are offering different path, easy path or difficult path, or we can say resistance offered. So what do you think, out of these three components, which component will offer more resistance? Ananya, which component will offer more resistance, 10 watt bulb or nichrome wire or torch bulb?
10 watt
bulb. Accurate, absolutely, because the resistance of 10 watt bulb is more, so the it will offer more resistance, and thus we need more potential difference to flow through it, and thus the electric current will be also more. When potential difference is more, the current value will be also more flowing through it. Agree to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
So on the basis of this activity, we come to know that some of the components of the same size, suppose we have this type of the component which are known as resistors, if we had taken certain resistors, then a conductor having some appreciable resistance is called resistor. This type of the resistors you must have seen in small device like remote or some of the radio or your transistors. Some of the things have been opened by chance or broken, then you must have seen this type of the resistors are there, right? A component of a given size that offers a low resistance is a good conductor. So what was the good conductor in our activity? A nichrome wire or a nichrome wire. Yes, nichrome wire was the good conductor. And resistor was? 10 watt bulb, right? And suppose I place a plastic wire and I put small amount of the water, what will be it known as, poor conductor or insulator?
Insulator.
No, I have insulator. Water also, beta. Small amount of salty water I have put on it, so it has become poor conductor. It has
poor
become
conductor.
Poor conductor, right? Clear to you, right? So the component of identical size that offers a higher resistance is called poor conductor, right? An insulator of same size which offers even higher resistance is known as insulator. Clear to everyone? So this way, on the basis of difference of current flowing through the different devices, we can classify them into the four types: insulator, resistor, poor conductor, and conductor or a good conductor. Is it clear? Now, what we are going to learn today is activity 12.3 to show that the factors affecting the resistance of a wire or a conducting material, right? So how we can increase the resistance value or decrease the value, what are the various factors that we will study in this activity. What we have done, again, we have taken the same circuit as in the Ohm's law. There is a cell, ammeter is connected in the series, and XY slot, in this one by one, we are going to put different material or the different length or thickness of the wires. In first case, we have taken a thin wire of nichrome wire. In second case, we have increased the length of the wire. What do you think? When we have increased the length of the wire, the current will be more or less?
Ma'am, less.
Why less? Because resistance was inversely proportional to current. We have learned when we have done the resistance, V is equal to IR and R is equal to V upon I. We have done this. R is equal to V upon I. So we said R is inversely proportional to current, right? So if we have increased the length, resistance have increased. Therefore, the value of current will get decrease or increase. The value of current will increase or decrease. So we have noticed in this that as the resistance was inversely proportional to the current, as we have increased the length, the resistance of the wire got increased and the current value shown in our ammeter have decreased. Right? It has decreased. Now suppose in third case, I have made same length as in the first case. Suppose we have taken 2 centimeter length of the wire. Same way we have taken 2 centimeter length of the wire, but the thickness is increased. Suppose in case one, the thickness was 0.01 mm, right? And in second case, I have increased the thickness to double. Suppose it has increased to 0.02 mm, right? So what do you think? The resistance will increase or decrease?
Resistance will increase.
Thickness. The resistance.
Ma'am, increase.
Ma'am, increase.
Or decrease?
Ma'am, increase.
Resistance will increase. Or decrease. Think again.
Ma'am, increase.
I am increasing the thickness. That means area is increasing. Circular wire hai. तो इसका एरिया क्या होगा पाई आर स्क्वायर ठीक है
राइट
सो इफ आई एम इंक्रीजिंग द एरिया द रेजिस्टेंस विल इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज
मैम डिक्रीज मैम इट विल
रेजिस्टेंस विल डिक्रीज सो इफ रेजिस्टेंस विल डिक्रीज देन द करंट विल
इंक्रीज
करंट विल
इंक्रीज
Resistance is decreased, so current will be increasing here. Is it clear? Right?
Yes,
now,
ma'am.
In the fourth case, what we have done, in the fourth case, we have changed the material. In first three cases, we were using the same material, suppose nichrome wire or copper wire, whatever we want to use. But in the fourth case, we have changed the material. Suppose we have used copper wire. And now in fourth case, we are using nichrome wire. What do you think? Current shown by the ammeter will be same or it will be different?
Ma'am, it will not be the same. It will increase.
It will be different. That means yes, if the value of current is changed, yes, the value of resistance is also changed. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Now
yes,
the fourth ma'am. Factor I yes, say. Ma'am. Fifth factor. Instead, I say. Fourth factor, I say that I have changed the temperature of this wire. Suppose I kept it in boiling water whose temperature is 70 degrees Celsius. What do you think? The temperature increase, current ki value change hogi ya nahi? Value of current will increase or decrease or change hogi ya nahi? Simply just tell me.
Ma'am, it will change.
It will change.
Ma'am, it will change.
And the resistance will be decreased or increased?
Decrease.
Increase or decrease? Decrease. Bilkul theek. Decrease is correct, Ananya. Why? Because the temperature is increased. So already the energy in form of the heat energy is being given to the wire. So we need to apply less potential difference. If we are applying less potential difference, the current value will be less. V is proportional to I as per the Ohm's law. Got it, everyone? So we can summarize.
Yes.
We can summarize that resistance of a conductor depends upon the various types of the factors. What are those? What are those?
Length.
Ma'am, length.
Section area
length,
and material. Very good.
It depends on the length. Next.
Ma'am, cross-section area.
Area of cross-section and material. It is inversely proportional, right? So children, what we have concluded from this activity, that resistance of the conducting material is depending upon the length, as you said, and we have observed that it is directly proportional to it. Means length is increased, resistance is also increased, and we have observed the current value has decreased or increased. Divya Prakash.
Ma'am, decreased.
Ma'am, decreased.
Yes, decrease because resistance is increased, right? And when we have changed the area of cross section, we observe the current value have
increased.
Again, decrease, beta, decrease because R is inversely proportional to area of cross section, right? Clear? Now, combining 1 and 2, here in the derivation, we will use 2 factors only. Otherwise, we have studied about 4 factors, right? So you can write down in your notes, R is resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to the length of the wire. Therefore, R is proportional to L. In the next line, write down resistance of the conductor is inversely proportional to the area of cross section. That means R is inversely proportional to A. A is the area of cross section. Now combine point number 3, resistance of a conductor depends upon material of the wire. And number 4, resistance of a conductor depends on the, what was the fourth factor?
Ma'am, temperature.
Temperature of the wire. Very good. Temperature of the wire. Is it clear? So we have done 4 factors, but numerically we can represent 2 factors only. So combining these 2, we said that R is proportional to L upon A. And as we know, when we remove the proportionality sign, we always get a constant value. And this constant is rho. Rho is again Greek letter. And this Greek letter rho represents the constant of proportionality, which is called the electrical resistivity or specific resistance of the material of the conductor. Right, G? Clear to everyone?